Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to be salt baking a sea bass. Now, this is a sea bass I caught on a 3-day trip out to Alderney a few weeks ago. It's a lovely sized fish, but because the channel is all about food smoking, I have to put my own little smoky twist on this. So I'm going to be salt baking this bass in some smoked salt. So the first thing I need to do really is to show you how I smoke the salt. And I really want to get a lot of flavor into this salt because that's really important. I don't want this to be quite a weak flavor, but salt baking should really impart some flavor to the fish. And in order to do that, we need to get as much smoky flavor into that salt as possible. So let me show you how I do that. Right, that should be enough salt. And I'm going to be cold smoking this in my smoker. So we'll give it as much surface area as we can. We're going to smoke this for about 3 days just to give it a really amazing color and get all those beautiful smoky flavors in there. After we've smoked it for a day, we're going to mix it all up and then put it back in the smoker, and we'll keep doing that until we get a really delicious color on this. Right, let's crack on, get this in the smoker.
I'm using my trusted old artisan cold smoke generator from ProQ. I sell these on my website, coldsmoking.co.uk. The link is in the description. The cold smoker I'm using for this project is the Norman cold smoker, which comes all the way from Norway and is perfect for this application. I'll leave a link to their website and socials in the video description. I'm loading it with an equal mixture of beech and oak wood dust. You can find all these products in the description of the video. This smoke generator will burn for about 18 hours, giving a light to medium smoke density, and is perfect for cold smoking as it generates very little heat when it's smouldering away. Ideally, when cold smoking, you want the temperature to be below 30 degrees Celsius, but as we're cold smoking salt, we're less concerned about the temperature, as salt isn't affected by any excess heat likely to be found in this application. The reason I have a smoke generator here sitting on a metal tray is because the cold smoker has a base made from wood, and we don't want any inadvertent or unwanted combustion taking place below where we're actually generating the smoke from. Sitting it on a metal tray gives us that little bit of confidence that we're not going to get any embers burning down and setting fire to the smoker. That would not be a good thing. When you purchase one of these artisan smoke generators, they come with a small tea light. Now, because I've got quite large fingers, I can't really get my fingers in to get the tea light out readily, so I tend to use a brûlée torch or a small blow lamp to light the cold smoke generator. I find that a lot easier and a lot less faff. Also, you don't have to muck around finding tea lights every time you want to light this thing. Right, it's down with the lid and let's get this thing smoking.
Okay, it's now the next day. This has been smoking all night. And you can see that it has all burned. Yeah, that's great. So we'll refill this and we'll get it back in. So if you look carefully, you can see this has got a bit gummed up, but it should be okay for another couple of burns. If you want to know how to clean these, then I've got a video on the channel describing my method for cleaning these, so I'll leave a link to that in the description. In the meantime, we're going to give this another refill, get it going, and give it another 18 or so hours of smoking. There we go, that's ready to go. We'll leave that for a little while. Oh, incidentally, let me just show you very quickly. I've got some chilies from the garden that I popped in here, just on top. We've got the smoke salt underneath. Let's take a look at that. There's the salt underneath. That's getting some nice colour to it. That's really nice. I'll give that a quick whiz over with a spoon, actually, just so that we get some fresh salt on top. Okay, this is our salt. You can see the smoke on it once you get the spoon in and give it a good old turnover. And we just want to really expose as much of this to the smoke as possible. That's lovely. Leave that spoon in there. And we'll come back to this in about another 18 hours. Oh, and we'll let these chilies do their thing as well. Lovely smoked chili, that'll be delicious when they're done. This has now been smoking for 3 days. Oh, look at my chilies there. They look a bit lovely, don't they? They're all nice. I just need to dry those a bit more. Right, more about those later. But here is this smoked salt. And as soon as I move it, you can see the colours in there. And that's all that lovely smoke has infused the flavour into that salt. And this is what we're going to use to bake this sea bass. Lovely.
In total, I did 3 complete burns with the Artisan cold smoke generator. Each burn was approximately 18 hours long, so this salt has been cold smoked for a total of around 54 hours. And you can see the colour has changed significantly, and I can assure you it smells absolutely beautiful.
Right, so the first thing I need to do is to take the scales off this sea bass, and I use this spoon to do that, and I just work from the tail, rubbing it onto the fish to remove those scales. And if you do it underwater, all those scales don't go flying all over the kitchen. Let me crack on, don't want to bore you with all the details. Right, let's get the salt made. Idiot. Oh well, 3 out of 4 is not bad.
So, as you can see, my egg white separation technique isn't all that good, as the first yolk broke. Don't worry too much if this happens, as it's not going to affect the outcome. All we are using the egg whites for is to create a binder, so the salt holds together around the fish as it cooks in the oven. Now we're mixing these egg whites into the smoked salt, and we're trying to get all that salt incorporated into the egg white so that we create almost like a dry, sandy mix, so that when we press it against the fish, it tends to hold and forms a layer around the whole fish without crumbling away or cracking.
Let's get our tray. our fish. First thing we're going to do is pop some of this into here. Warmer base. And we're going to put the fish onto this. We don't want it to touch the bottom, we want it to be completely surrounded. Some lemon slices in here. A little bit of black pepper. Yes, this is where you get your hands busy. And you want to really press this down to form a crust all over this fish. Press any air gaps out. Skewer through and just see if I can feel. Okay, could probably do with just being in the oven for another minute or two. Well, I've taken the crust off here. Look at that. I mean, it's absolutely solid, and I've done it really carefully, trying to preserve as much of the fish as possible. We've lost a little bit of the tail. That's okay, and I'm going to try and lift this fish clean out onto this plate. There we go. From there, I can take the bones out of this. Okay, we've taken all the meat off the bone. Here is what we are taking to the table. Can't wait to taste this. Let's have a little taste now. Oh yeah, that's absolutely delicious. It's got a really nice kind of seasoned, salty flavour. That's delicious. Can't wait for that to sit on my plate.
Oh, and I nearly forgot. Those chili flakes that I was smoking in the smoker alongside the salt turned out really nicely. What I did is I dried them a little bit more in the oven, blitzed them in a coffee grinder, and hey presto, there they are.
Well, I hope you liked the video. It was quite an interesting experiment. I've never done a salt baked fish before, and I thought, well, adding my little smoky twist to it might be a good thing to do. So, in summary, I think if you want to smoke salt as a gourmet option, then this is basically how you cold smoke salt. If you want to do a salt baked fish, this is a good method to show you how to do a salt baked fish. But Would I do a smoked salt bait fish again? Well, I'm not 100% sure that I got the amount of flavor that I thought I was gonna get from it. So in terms of this video, I think if you wanna do cold smoked salt, then this is the way to go. It's a great way of doing salt, but I wouldn't generally use PDV salt, which is the salt I was using. I would generally go for a higher end salt. If you're gonna make a gourmet smoked salt, don't use ordinary table salt. Go and get yourself something nice like a Maldon sea salt. If you're gonna salt bake, obviously the method stands. It's a good way of cooking. It tends to retain the moisture in the fish, and I think it's a very sympathetic way of cooking. You got to be careful though. You saw me test with that probe. When I tested with that probe, I touched it on the upper part of my lip just to gauge whether or not it was warm enough. And you can tell quite accurately using that method. If you can't hold it on your lip, then it's done pretty much. I hope you liked the video. If you got something from it, please do consider subscribing to the channel. We'll post all sorts of interesting stuff about food smoking, meat curing and charcuterie. And if you like the video, then please give it a big thumbs up, and hopefully we'll see you on the next video. In the meantime, folks, take care of yourself, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.